Welcome to Sandwiches in History. Today, from the Searchlight Household Cookbook of 1958, we're going to be making the apricot and horseradish sandwich. That's right, I said apricot and horseradish. Now, in 1958, President Dwight D. Eisenhower became the first elected official in the United States to appear on color television. Rice-A-Roni, the San Francisco treat, was first marketed. An amazing actor, Angela Bassett, was born. So in the video, you're going to see me use apricots that look like this. Not like this. And these are the ones you probably see at the grocery store all the time. They are preserved with sulfur dioxide after they're dried, and that keeps their color looking like that. These are preserved without, which is actually more true to what the apricots would have been like for the recipe. So to a pot, we add dried apricots, water. Now we simmer slowly until the fruit is softened. Okay, it's taking about 40-45 minutes to get these softened, but now we add sugar, cook for another 5 minutes. All right, now we drain them, and now we mash them to a paste. And we put that onto buttered whole wheat bread. Now it says to add horseradish to taste. And it did not say prepared horseradish, so I'm using the root. Gotta stay fresh. Okay, let's give this apricot and horseradish sandwich a go. It's interesting. The really tangy, sharp horseradish does contrast with the sweet apricots. Ooh, man, I don't know. I think I am gonna try and plus this up. Yeah, those flavors just didn't really work together for me at all. And I don't think using prepared horseradish would make a big difference, or any difference, really. It just didn't work for me. I didn't want to waste additional food trying to make it better when it was already really not great. So I'm going to give the apricot and horseradish sandwich a 2. It has nutritional value. It's on whole wheat bread. But yeah, I am not going to finish that. All right, I'm going to have something else for lunch. See you tomorrow.